Miho Shinoda.
Arab Spring straight, back mount.
Flick, two somersaults. Got to watch those combinations closely. Quite a lot of gymnasts do two flicks and then one somersault. Much more difficult to do one flick and two somersaults.
Yes, she's just got a telltale trailing bent leg. So she could lose 3/10 on that one length. Good front, though. The handstand just short of the split. They could knock off marks for lack of amplitude. In other words, lack of total range of movement in a given skill. Dismount, few little wobbles in the middle, but the routine had all of the specifications, all of the difficulties required. It'll be marked out of 10. Lowing on A bars, 9.875.
As Chen Kuiting steps on to the floor. 9.9, she started off with on beam, so well in contention.
Kuiting and Fandi have a fresh look about them, hair well pulled back, just a little bit of makeup to sell their beautiful faces. It really adds to the attraction of their appearance.
Nice tight double back. So much more graceful when those legs aren't split to increase the rotation. She's 18 years old and she trains a phenomenal 6 hours a day. She's just losing her poise there on that pirouette.
These little pirouettes appear so simple, but they just aren't. She's landed the double back, she's done everything perfectly. And on that pirouette, she totally lost her balance, and they could dock her 2/10. What a shame. So beautiful.
A student from Hunan province. Pretty shot of Daniela Silivash, watching everything with great interest, looking at new moves, new combinations.
Excellent tumbling, feet and knees glued together. The feet were even stretched on the way round in a double back, and this is something that we don't often see.
Christina Bontash, the leader at the moment.
She really is a little powerhouse, but unfortunately she has a habitual split of the legs as she leaves the board to take off for the horse, and that really is a slow kick of the leg in the Arab Spring.
Brandy Johnson to asymmetric bars. Lovely high catch of Jaeger somersault.
And the really high scorers on the asymmetric bars have as few A moves in as possible. That's the little moves, the upstarts. Now that was an excellent routine. She only had two or three A elements in. All the rest were C's and D's, movements of the greatest difficulty.
She Shinoda's beam, 9.712, and Christina Bontash's first vault, 9.862. She's got to get up into the 9.9s.
Double-twisting Yurchenko. Nice wind-up of the arms into a very fast twist, but still the parting of the legs preventing her from getting a perfect score.
It is a peculiar little quirk in her gymnastics. She seems to throw one leg faster than the other.
Karine Mehmet from France. Years old.
Four move combination. It's unusual. Flick somersault, flick somersault. Most gymnasts can only get three in.
One-legged handspring, had quite a wobble after it, and then the front somersault to seat. Still a little off balance, backward roll to handstand. Tricky move to do on the beam. This is the reason why most of the gymnasts have their hair in ponytail or plaits, because in backward rolls, it's very easy to make yourself a little bald in a few places. Oh dear, bad fall there. 0.5 away, a pity she managed to hang on in the middle when she could have easily fallen.
But her first big championship, she's just 15 years old, and this, a lovely example of the work she can produce. A four move travel along the beam.
America's Wendy Bruce onto floor. Gymnasts now in their second rotation.
Yes, you say just in the second rotation, but after this they're halfway through the competition, because the women only perform on four pieces. That makes every error even more glaring.
Isn't judged just for the tumbles, it's judged for the trickiness of these little transitional skills. Sometimes they take months to learn and perfect. That type of movement's just a fill-in to get them a little breath of fresh air before they go into the next tumble. Now she needs some scoring dance. Any leap with a full turn is a scoring element. Pirouettes, that's a double pirouette, that's a scoring element. With the combination of the jump on the end of it, that raises its value. Now the final tumble. Three tumbles are needed at the minimum. Plenty of variety there, but the standard of the tumbling was pretty poor. Always had her feet far too wide in the click combination.
Right, we better get some marks away. Christina Bontash on vault, the most important, 9.875 only, so that really nullifies that 10 on the floor. Johnson Zabar's 9.925, and Chen Kui-ting on floor 9.937.
Kim Gwang-suk from Korea on vault. She really is dinky. She's about 130 centimetres, just about eye level, that horse. And she's bottles out, she can run underneath it. Arab spring onto the board. That's the backhand spring, 1.5 somersault and one twist in the middle.
Mehmet, 9.25 for her beam. Cho Kyung-hui from North Korea onto the uneven bars.
This is what I mean about linking difficulty after difficulty. Just two simple moves to get from one bar to the other now. Kachev, that's called an upstart, that's an A element. Now a big element, that's a full twisting giant into the double back. Lovely high Jaeger, and the transition from the top to the bottom bar, really high and immediately into a stolder. That's a clear circle and a straddle. Bruce on floor, scored 9.925.
Kim Gwan-suk, her first fault, 9.812. Oh, and stuck the landing beautifully. She's never going to be able to get the flight phase looking elegant and long, but she therefore has to make sure everything else is perfect. Now, needing a big score, Svetlana Boginskaya.
And that was a very low front somersault match. She nearly gave herself a haircut.
And she's waving to the audience there too. Not a good start. .95 for her A bars.
Boginskaya always produces some very unusual shapes. It appears to me that the Russians are going out of their way to be different. And I would call this a play-safe routine. Her jumps are low. That was supposed to be two flicks and a somersault, and she did three flick-flacks. I appear to be knocking her, but we're very aware of what she can do and what she is doing. And she is going to be marked on what she is doing now, not what she does in warm-up.
Landed beautifully, though. Pulled it together at the end, but that will be a very interesting score to watch, because that was not Boginskaya, for me, anywhere near her best. There was the flick back, and there all the waving to the crowd that was not intended. Olga Strajeva.
Gabriela Potorak to floor. Plenty of aggression into that first tumble. She needed it because she was struggling, just got to her feet. Difficult dance combinations, change leg split leaps on different legs. Trouble there, double twist into punch front, but it went wrong. Landed the best. Really unfortunate, Potorak. Her opening tumble was really short, and then out of the double twist, she stuck her hips back and missed the punch front.
Now Olga Strajeva. She's vaulting in this rotation. the first one to make sure that she's going to get a really high mark.
And to the asymmetric bars, China's Fan Di. Now in the voluntary section of the World Championships in 1987, Fan Di scored a 10 for a magnificent routine. They are the reasons for getting a 10 when her Jaeger, it almost goes into orbit. There she goes again. Adequate quantity and wonderful quality.
Just a tiny little step forward on landing, the rest of it, absolute bliss. Well, Boginskaya scored 9.95 for her beam routine, but to show you how people differed on it, I was looking at the scoring very closely. One judge had a 9.8 up, that's about where I'd have marked it, and another judge had a 10. They were the bottom and tops that went, and the average of the other four brought it out to 9.95. Cho Byung-hui, 9.85 on A-bars. And now we're waiting for Fan Di's score.
Having a closer look at this wonderful work, I sometimes think that the landings after such a wonderful routine are over-deducted. Strasheva's second vault.
She scored 9.962 for the first.
Very similar vault, landed with a straddled right leg. She does have problems, John, with one of those ankles.
Iveta Polakova from Czechoslovakia onto beam. She had that terrible start to her competition, 8.475 on her P-bars, and it really isn't her day.
Mind you, that's a very difficult move. It's a front somersault with a half twist. I've only seen one other gymnast produce it, and that was Lavinia Agashi from Romania. That was about 4 years ago, so not many people have copied it since then. They don't fancy doing it, neither would I.
That's a constant challenge in gymnastics. You've got to go for the difficulty, but then if you don't make it, you pay the penalty, and she cannot now score more than 9.5.
Polakova, a lovely gymnast. Czechoslovakians have always made their mark in European and World Championships, getting finalists, but never have really blossomed since the days of Vera Chislavska, who won the gold medal at the 68 Olympics in Mexico and the 66 World Championships. Well, my heart goes out to her because the World Championship is the result of years of training, and for it all to go wrong is very disheartening.
Bärbel Bilgos from East Germany onto the floor. Potorak before her only scored 9.75, so the Romanians really not doing nearly so well in the second round.
Thank you. Herbal Vilgos triple twist to open and an innovative middle tumble. It's a similar than many we see, but instead of being straight, it was in the pike shape into the Arabian 1 3/4 roll.
The Germans trying to start a mini wave there at the end of the second round. A couple of scores that are vital. Fandy 9.95 for that A bars, but there's the woman in the lead now. Olga Strajeva at the end of two rounds has overtaken the Romanians, 19.924 with 2 9.962. Daniela Silivash holds on to second place. Boginskaya has gone up to third, and Fandy is in fourth. We'll take another break there. They're halfway through. Two more breathtaking rounds to come. Join us then. Welcome back. This women's individual all-round championship living up to everything we expected. The one great thing about this new form of competition is that you don't miss anything. You do see every single exercise. Normally, we need eyes in the back of our heads. But looking at the positions at the moment, Olga Strajeva takes the lead. She's got 19.924, but you go right down to Potorak in 16th position, and she's on 19.737. That's 0.187 between first and 16th in this group. It shows you how tight it is. All the scores now into hundredths, because the judges are allowed to mark to two decimal points. You can go to half a tenth, as it were. They can get a 0.05 in, and that means that when you average out the four middle scores that count, they get hundredths very often indeed. Boginskaya, she's moved up into third place. 2 9.95s for her. And as you can see in this rotation, she goes on four. Meanwhile, Daniela Silivash Silivash this time on asymmetric bars. And the leader, I thought for a moment, but it's not, it's Lashinova. She's over on vault. Strajeva with Silivash on the A bars. First to go in this rotation, though, Chen Kuiting from China.
Kuiting in eighth position. Oh, lovely vault. She really was very, very casual about her run-up, because she is a very explosive gymnast. Some gymnasts have a lot of fast twitch muscle fiber in their bodies, short, stocky muscles, which are very, very powerful. So she doesn't need too much cross speed, otherwise she'll fly to the back of the mat. See the lift she gets off the apparatus and the distance from not a lot of cross speed.
Yes, very slow on the run in, and you'd often think that was going to be the mark of perhaps a poor vaulter, but not so in her case.
And to the asymmetric bars, Daniela Silivash, a lovely top bar combination, endo straight into Delchev.
Well, in fact, the confusion worrying us all there, but for some reason there has been a delay on the asymmetric bars, and that was Daniela Silivash finishing off her practice. I wonder what I was seeing for a moment. She's last up on that piece, and Henrietta Anodi from Hungary is the first up. Gymnasts meant to complete their warm-up in the 3 minutes available, but on the asymmetric bars there's a lot of chalking up to do, and even in practice they like to get it dead right, so they're allowed longer.
Kuiting's first vault 9.950, now to Onodi on the asymmetric bars. Gold medalist in this event at the on the individual apparatus, rather, in the European Championships. Lovely little full pirouette. Nice way of getting to the top bar. Ginga. Forward giant into Jaeger. Some wonderful work here, John.
Yes, it's the sheer volume of the moves she puts in. You see other people do them higher and longer, but what you were saying about not using A moves for linking, she just goes from one difficulty straight to another.
Well, that was beautiful. 10 moves or 11 are expected as a minimum in a bar routine, and there were 19 elements at least. Lovely hop change on the top into that forward giant, release for the Jaeger, drop straight to the bottom bar. That's the upstart.
Chen Kuiting's second vault. She scored 9.95 for the first. It really is a sort of dainty little run. Trots along, big step back on that landing.
She really daren't to run any faster. In my gym, I have to hire a bulldog to chase my gymnast down the runway.
On beam, Larissa Lowing from Canada. .9912 on vault, .9.875
on A bars. Aerial cartwheel into Corbett. Hard to combine a twist movement into a straight movement. Showing variety of her tumbles. Standing tuck back, again, first introduced by Corbett in 74, now only a B element. Simplest elements are A's, and the most difficult are D's. And then you can have added bonus points. Big step back on the dismount, but safe and full of variety.
Miho Shinoda from Japan, first up on floor in this rotation.
A greatly improved gymnast. She was only 35th in the 87 Worlds. And after the team championship was 17th.
Two twists there.
Coach is Sukahara. He's a hard taskmaster. I noticed that if any of the gymnasts come off the floor and they haven't done very well, he never ever smiles. He was the innovator of the vault, Sukahara.
And the Japanese flags waving in the crowd. Onodi's A-bar score, 9.925. Larissa Lowing, 9.775 for that beam.
And Wendy Bruce to vault. Two vaults for the girls. They can do the same, or two different ones. must say that they're sadly lacking variety, considering that there are some 60 volts in the code of points. They've all opted for the either the Yurchenko or the Sukuhara. Now Christina Bontash.
She went so well in the first round, but fell back in the second, right down in 16th place. Gets through the catch of Adrian Goriak, the coach, standing in, but not necessary, thank goodness. And a double tuck-back finish, landed it nicely, a bit too much travel in it.
Yes, but clean. It's good to see the coaches being permitted onto the podium to shadow the gymnasts, because really, it's not giving them any false security, but in the essence of safety, when they're producing skills of such difficulty, it really does protect them. Shinoda scored 9.837 on floor.
Wendy Bruce, 9.9 for the first vault. Here she goes on the second. It's the same one, and a bit short on that. You can see how she had to step forward. I don't think she'll improve.
Yes, really came in short there, dropped the chest and stepped forward.
Brandy Johnson onto beam.
She comes from Tallahassee in Florida and trains at Brown's Gym, Brown's Academy. Her coach, Kevin and Rita, are on the floor with her. Brown's Gym is in Orlando, right next to Disneyland. Slight hesitation there, just moved out of it nicely. Good. Got a good set of scores behind her. That should be another high score.
Well, the judges obviously saw something in Wendy Bruce's second vault that I didn't. They marked it up just a shade, 9.912. Karim Mermé from France onto the floor. From Besançon, 15 years old, so this her first really big championship. She, apart from the Europeans last May, she competed in the Junior Europeans in 1988 in Avignon, and again, that's a bit of an experience, overcooking the tumbling run.
Scoring leaps. Oh, a little twist of the ankle there. Always give themselves a little pause to take breath for the final run. Double back.
Well, quickly, Christina Bontash is on even bars, score 9.9. That won't pull her up enough. And Brandy Johnson's beam, 9.887.
Nice 1.5 twisting walk out into the double back, but stepping out of the area, losing hundredths of a point there.
Little Gabriela Potorak to vault. And again, the Yurchenko with full twist. I'm getting fed up with them.
Well, we know she can do a double twisting, Yurchenko, because she got a silver medal in Seoul for that. So I think she'll have to put a bit more effort in to get round in two twists, because that is a little bit of a lazy vault.
But maybe she'll go for it this time. No change, though, there in that tariff mark, you can see. Kim Gwang-suk from North Korea.
And there's the new move that everybody's been waiting for. That was incredible. I mean, she did a catch-ev and then came underneath as if she was going to do another catch-ev. Extra swing, it's gone wrong. Spectacular stuff.
Giant with full pirouette and then the dismount. Now here's the new element coming back up to the catch-of. Almost going to swing into it again, but then stops it and goes back round the other way. Magnificent. Mermet's floor 9.725, and Gabriela Potorak's first vault 9.912. Now will she put in another twist to get herself back into contention, perhaps? Now I could see the board which told us which vault she was going to do. It was still that same tariff number, so the same vault has gone a bit lazy, hasn't it? Do you think that's because she's grown a bit, Monica?
Yeah, she's probably outgrown her strength for a little while. She's just at that age, but she'll strengthen in the next year. But with the World Championships, they haven't been able to devote a lot of time to it.
Cho Gyeong-hui from North Korea onto the beam. Gymnast has to put all those boos away from her. They're in fact for the score that's been put up on the asymmetric bars for Kim Gwang-suk, 9.612 only, but what the crowd didn't know was that it went wrong in the middle. They didn't realize the significance of the extra swing. Monica Phelps, of course, did, and that's a 3/10 deduction, so about as high as she could possibly have got.
Nice combination. Whip back somersault, the last one, not a straight back, shoulders leading the way into the somersault. Choi, a very elegant performer. Smashing. Knew where the floor was there.
Svetlana Boginskaya. Third position after two rotations. Look at the look in her eyes. Very tall, 1.62 meters. She'll get found in that. Full twisting back somersault easily.
Really a beautiful movement. The intricacy of her spins and jumps in between the tumbles that are high scoring too. Baginski has done very well to recover from the death of her coach in 1988. She then had to change coaches after being coached by the same lady for 6 years. Held the landing. Step back out of that double back wasn't illegal. Now that was a beautiful double pirouette at the end. Well, I think that's the most expressive thing that I've ever seen Baginski produce. Very, very dramatic and sensuous.
That extra height she has over most of the other girls does make her very, very elegant. The twisting run. Potterack scored 9.937 for her second vault, so that's the one that will count. And Choi Kyung Hui, 9.85. And a 10 for Baginski. Well, I know, Monica, you think it was worth it.
Yes, I do. I hate injustice. When she got a 10 on bars the other day, I didn't like it, but that was certainly worth the 10. Is Germany on vault? With Birbal Milgos.
Olga Strajeva, who had taken the lead at the end of the second round. Asymmetric bars, her third piece.
Jansrud mounts, Shapoznikova into uprise. These are extremely difficult combinations.
Two 9.962s so far on floor and vault.
Pity about that.
And that's the sort of thing that loses world championships. Now, what would you deduct for that, Monica?
Probably a tenth, I would think, at the most. Because in the middle, she had so many combinations far superior to anybody else we've seen, that the dismount will be judged accordingly. And the dismount was a bonus dismount, full in, back out. She had her feet stretched all the way around. Beautiful form, just under-rotated.
9.887, Bielgos's first vault. Very low in the landing there on that twisting Yurchenko.
Am Spielbalken aus der Volksrepublik China, Handli.
And the standard so high that Strajeva's landing at the end of the floor. 9.9 could still take her off the lead. Fendi onto beam.
And everybody's allowed to have a favourite gymnast, and this is mine.
Oh, forward roll. It looks so simple. I think quite a few of the crowd agree with you, Monica. Their great groan of disappointment as she fell from all around the arena. But that forward roll, with no hands on beam, a very difficult move. She was up into fourth place halfway through.
Not just the boldness with which she goes for her elements, but She hardly ever looks at the beam. She assumes the beam is there. And the roll on which she fell off is only a B element. It's hardly worth anything.
Well, you read the Strajeva A-bars exactly right. 9.925 her score. That means that Boginski has gone ahead of her. As we see a dejected Van D leave the podium. Not as dejected, though, perhaps...